Systems traditionally has been in the manufacture of defense related equipment, whether it's land-based, sea-based or air-based. The Applied Intelligence Division that I work for focuses primarily on cyber defense. As you know, in this day and age, there is that proliferation of a lot of that cybersecurity threats that we're seeing. And that's where Applied Intelligence comes in with its forte, with its value add to be able to help not only commercial organizations, but government agencies and nations as well against a potential threat from cyber attacks. And the way that we do it is with various options and across multiple industry segments. So to pick an example, with the banking finance sector, we offer a solution that's called anti-money laundering. Essentially, it helps banking financial institutions mitigate themselves against risks of potential money laundering threats. Value proposition. It's a prime advantage to a lot of the multinational corporations that are outside of the ASEAN region, if you like, in picking and choosing ASEAN by itself. One primary factor obviously is the huge population growth that we have in this region, a fast developing economy, a country that's chasing after a lot of the transformation and changes that's already happening in the larger economies as well. So that's a prime advantage I see. Second, obviously, is we have ourselves gone through multiple waves of outsourcing and shared services type models, and I think we are primed to be able to set ourselves up to move up the value chain and start doing more value-added services in that context. It's around being ready and to be able to adapt and adopt to a lot of the changes that's coming, the disruptive changes that's coming. More importantly is making sure that we've got the talent that's aligned to a lot of the changes that's coming as well. We have enough people who are available in the talent pool to be able to hire, but I think there's a mismatch between where the people are available versus the kind of jobs that's available, and I think we need to be able to bridge that gap, whether it's through the education channels, whether it's through the HR organizations within the organizations themselves, is coming together and making sure that collaboration takes place between industry, academia, as well as the agencies to make sure that we are building that ability to bridge that gap. It's a great platform for us to be able to share and discuss very openly and candidly what are some of the challenges that we see in the market space at this moment. Secondly, the industry leads themselves are able to understand from each other in terms of similar challenges that they face and how is it that they can pick the lessons learned from some of this organization and apply that directly. Thirdly, I think it's also an opportunity for the industry to be able to voice their concerns via the different policy makers, if you like, to be able to help influence the outcomes that they are looking for.